Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for this nice day. Hallelujah. I thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus, for this fine, wonderful day. Lord, I thank you for all the facilities, for everything. Lord, let your power be released today. That's my prayer, Lord. Hallelujah. So today, Holy Spirit told me to preach about the model prayer. We all need prayer. Without prayer, we cannot live. Without prayer, we cannot survive. Prayer is essential for us. In order to have our prayer request answered, we should surely pray to God. If we do not pray, you know what will happen. We won't get deliverance. Today, this time, what I am telling you is about the prayer, how we should pray. We know that the fastest thing in the world, many think that it is the light is the fastest thing. But I am saying that the fastest thing, second fastest thing in this world is prayer. And the fastest thing in the world is God's reply. When we pray, God will reply very soon. If we are confident and if we are pure in heart, surely I say that in the name of Jesus that God will reply even before. In the book of Isaiah 65, chapter 65, 24th verse, it says that even before you pray, I will answer you. So the fastest thing in this world is God's reply to us. And the second fastest thing is prayer. But today many people do not know how to pray. I had an auntie, my relative. She used to say that I am always praying. She thinks that praying is only just killing the time. But no. According to her, prayer is maybe killing the time. Whenever she gets free time, she will go and kneel down and pray. That's not prayer. Prayer is keeping separate time. Separate time, that is talking with God. Prayer means talking with God. If you have any problem, like you talk to somebody else, you are talking to God. Then God will listen to you also. If you pray to God, that means if you talk to God for 15 minutes, 15 minutes you have to wait there in order to get the reply from God. Many people after praying, they will go get up and they won't even listen what God has said. God has to talk to us many things. He has to tell us many things. But realize one thing. If you pray, if you have a prayer life, you must also keep some time for God to answer to your prayers. Today I am telling you the model of prayer. How you will have to pray. Because in the book of Matthew chapter 6, 5th verse, it says that you should not be like the heathen. You should not like the hypocrites. You should not be like the ordinary people. You know, the hypocrites, when they pray, they will go to the public place and they want to show that their prayer should be seen by other people. And you know, the heathens, they pray, they call their names. Whatever gods they have, they call their names 100 times, maybe 1,000 times. They say like this, they tell their names like that. They think that if they recite the names of their God, their gods will answer. But understand one thing today, that Jesus has said in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, it says that, chapter 6, 8th verse, it says that, our Father knows what you need before you pray. Before you ask, our Father in heaven knows everything. He has called everything, He has prepared everything for us, and after that He has called us. So, we need not to say our Father, Father, we need that, we need this. Because our Father knows what we know. Whatever our children know, wants, we know. Is it correct? Whatever our children, my children are studying, whatever they need, I know. But because even before they ask, I will give them everything what they want. Likewise, our Father in heaven knows everything what we want. Today, this time, I am telling you. Hallelujah. Jesus has told how to pray. Because Jesus has taught us in the book of Matthew, chapter 9, it says that you pray like this. That is the model prayer which Jesus has taught us. Our Father in heaven. Because our Father is in heaven and Jesus is the Son of God. And hallowed be your name. Hallelujah. Hallowed be your name. That is, many people are misusing the name of God. the God's name is misused in this world. Many prophets, many priests, many believers, many ordinary people are misusing the name of God. So it is our duty, as a servant of Christ, I am saying that it is our duty to make the name of God holy. Because our prayer to God first is, God, make your name holy. That's why Jesus said, hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be your name. Hallelujah. Then Jesus said that, let your kingdom come. Lord, it is not our will that should be accomplished in our life, but let your kingdom come. You know that when Jesus was in the cross, he was suffering because of very pain, because he was thrown with the everything, he was thrown like that. But you know, people bet him, scourged him, everything. He was tortured, everything, and he was crying with pain. You know what Jesus said? Jesus said, Father, let your will be accomplished, not my will. Let your will be accomplished, not my will. So your prayer must be like, Lord, my Father, let your kingdom come, not my kingdom, not my wish, but your kingdom come in my house. Let your kingdom come in this earth where I reside. Let that be your prayer. Hallelujah. And you know what Jesus has said? Jesus said in that prayer that, give us this day our daily bread. Jesus is teaching us that we should not ask for the tomorrow's prayer request. Tomorrow, as there will be a day tomorrow, and God will supply us everything tomorrow. So today, what you have, you pray for today's needs. Many people that come to me for prayer, their prayer requests are for 7 weeks after, maybe some months after. One sister came to my church and told me, I want a prayer request. I asked, what is your prayer request? She told that her house is going to be forfeited by the bank authorities. So you pray. I told, when they are going to forfeit, when they are going to seize your property, your house. She said that after 3 months, they will come and take my property, everything. They will take away my things outside my out and drive me out from the house. She said like that. I told her that it is only after 3 months. You have 3 months, 90 days now to pray. You cry to God. God will do a miracle. I told her. She went, and after 3 months came. I didn't even think about that. After 3 months, she came and told that bank authorities changed their mind. They didn't forfeit the property. They didn't put my property, my house on auction. They didn't put that on sale. I asked, what happened? What miracle did God do? I asked her. Then she said that the bank authorities forgot to take the property on auction. They forgot to seize the property. That's the first time ever happened in the world, because nobody will forget about, but the manager and all the people in the bank, God made the bank authorities to forget about the forfeiture. Hallelujah. So our God is a God who does miracles. So you should not pray for tomorrow's needs or next month's need. What you pray is for, you must pray for today's need. Because whenever people come to me for prayer requests, I will tell them, do you have everything to eat till this evening? If you have everything for today evening, you go and pray and sleep very well. Tomorrow morning is in God's hands. It is not in our hands. So God will do, God knows what to do. So Jesus has said that, give us this day our daily bread. And he's not saying that you pray for tomorrow. So let your prayer be like that. You pray for today's need also. And in the model prayer of Jesus, he has taught us that forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Jesus is teaching us how to pray, because he's saying that, forgive us, Father, our debts as we forgive our debtors. If we do not forgive our brothers, if we do not have sympathy to our neighbors, then God won't show sympathy to us. God won't hear our prayers. Jesus has said a parable that there was a man who owed many debts to a master, and when the master called him to repay the debts, Man cried and said, I have no way to repay, so have pity on me, forgive, you pardon all the debts. You know what the master did? That master forgave that that person, and everything was turned aside. All that he didn't have to repay that. But you know what happened? That person who was pardoned, that person, while on the way, he met another servant, which that servant owed him many amounts. And when that this servant who was pardoned by the master, when he saw that servant, he told that you should repay my debts. Then that servant said that I do not have any means to repay, so you please forgive me. But you know what that servant said? He said that, no, I won't forgive you. I am going to put you in prison. And he was put in the thrown in the prison. When the news came to the master that this person, which who he forgave, who he pardoned all the debts, you know what happened? That master became angry and called that servant and told, I forgave you and I showed you pity, but you were cruel to that person. So I am also not pardoning you the debts which I have pardoned you always. So you repay everything or I am going to throw into prison. And since he was not able to repay it, he was thrown in the prison. Hallelujah. So this is the parable which Jesus taught. So this will happen. If we do not forgive to our brothers, if we do not show sympathy to our neighbors or to our friends, Jesus won't hear our prayer. Our Father in heaven doesn't hear our prayers. Hallelujah. So, Jesus is, as said in the model prayer, that for I should not, you must pray like this. Do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. When we live in this world, we will have temptation because the devil is always watching. He is not watching an ordinary person, but he is watching a believer. When a person comes to Jesus, when a person comes close to God, devil will keep all his eyes, attention, everything, and he will be concentrated in that believer and what that person is doing, and devil will try to tempt him. So, Jesus has taught in the prayer that your prayer should be like this. Lead us not into temptation and protect us from the doings of the evil, but deliver us from the evil. In the book of Hebrews, we can see that Jesus, in the book of Hebrews chapter 2, 18th verse, says that, for in that he himself has suffered being tempted, he is able to aid those who are tempted. Because Jesus also suffered a lot and he was also tempted and he had the experience, so he will help us. So when you go through any temptation, when you have any temptation, when you are in the having any bad habits like smoking, like some other things, you must cry to God, because he had been tempted by Satan, but he was not fallen in sin. So he is able to help us. I am telling you, brothers and sisters, those who are hearing, maybe somebody in your house, or somebody, maybe yourself, or somebody whom you know, they cannot come out of their bad habits. But you tell them about Jesus, and tell that Jesus was also tempted, but he was not fallen in the hands of devil, or he was not fallen in sin, because God's grace was upon Jesus and he was a son of God. So if we be like Jesus, if Jesus dwells in our heart, surely we will also be able to overcome our sinful life. We will be able to come from all our bad habits. I know many people in the internet, I know many people in Facebook, they cannot come out of the bad habits, because while watching Messenger, while watching internet, while watching YouTube, many youngsters do not come out of the bad movies. They are addicted to that. Today I am telling you that if you cry to Jesus, Lord Jesus, you help me, because the book of Hebrews chapter 2, 18th verse, it says that, for in that he himself has suffered being tempted, he is able to aid those who are tempted. So Jesus suffered a lot when he was tempted, but because of God's grace that was upon him, he overcame all the temptations. Those who are hearing this message, hallelujah, realize one thing. You can come out of your temptations. You won't be tempted anymore, because when the temptation comes, when Satan comes with you with a new temptation, you can rebuke the Satan in the name of Jesus. And you, if you resist the devil will run away from you. Today, this time, I am telling you, Jesus has taught us a model how to pray. Because many people do not know how to pray. Because Jesus taught us it is not our wish, but it is God's wish that should be accomplished in our life. And we should not pray for the tomorrow's needs. There will be a day tomorrow, and God will be there to answer our prayer tomorrow. So in the book of Matthew, chapter 18, in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, 34th verse, it says that, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about its own things. So you seek the kingdom, you seek about what God wants, then God will give you everything. Book of Isaiah, I told you before that, before you sit down to pray, before you kneel down to pray, everything will be answered, because our Father in heaven knows everything what we need. So today, this time, when I am preaching you about the model prayer, those who do not know, some people, I have a friend, he told me that it is very easy to pray. He's telling me that you are praying all the, when I was in Middle East, I was in a room where my friends were also there. When they see I am always praying, they say that it is easy for you to pray than doing anything. But you know, prayer is talking to God. When we pray, God will listen. When your child talk to you, will you not listen to your child? Likewise, we are God's children. When we pray, when we are talking, God will listen. And surely God will reply. God called Samuel in the night and called Samuel, but he didn't hear because he was not aware of God's voice. So many people are like that. They never, after praying, they will get up. They are in a hurry. They will take even 1 hour, 2 hours, or 3 hours for prayer, but they never stand there or sit there to listen what God wants them to do. So every morning, I'm telling you, when you wake up in the morning, you must first praise God. Then secondly, you must pray whatever prayer request you have, you say that to God, your Father. First praising, after then talking to God, telling your prayer request. Then after praying, you must sit there. How much time you spend for prayer, that same time you must sit there to listen what God wants you to do. If you listen, if you open your eyes, surely God will say what to do. Every day God will talk to me. I spend some time, I keep some time listening to what God wants me to do. So before coming to Jesus, or in my early days after receiving Jesus, I did not know to listen to God's reply. Because I simply pray, but I never knew what God is saying. Some prophets will tell me that God will say like this. But one day one prophet told me, you must stay in the room after some more time to listen what God wants you to do. If you stay there, if you sit there, surely God will talk to you. Our God is a God who has pity on us. When we cry in sorrow, when we pray in with tears in our eyes, surely God will reply. Hallelujah. So, today God is also going to speak to you. I see a woman who is watching here. She is under the addiction of alcohol, but she cannot come out of the situation. She is being tempted by the Satan in many ways. But today morning, Holy Spirit is saying that if you cry to God, if you cry to Jesus, surely Jesus will help you to come out of the situation. Hallelujah. So in the book of Romans, when we see that, we do in the book of Romans chapter 8, 26th verse, it says that we do not know how to pray. We do not know how to pray. The verse is saying that we do not know how to pray, but the Spirit helps us to pray. When you pray in flesh, when you pray in yourselves, you do not know what to pray, because you do not know what will happen tomorrow. You are praying for your prayer request only today morning. Maybe you are now praying, but when you pray, your prayer request will be what happened in your past, or what you know that will come in the future. But you do not know what Satan has put, what Satan has hidden, and that what will happen to you by an accident, you do not know that. Only God knows. Only the Holy Spirit knows. So that's why Paul is saying in the book of Romans that you must pray in tongues. When you pray in tongues, hallelujah. When you pray in tongues, the Spirit prays with unknown language which you cannot understand. But God, who looks into the heart, but God who watches the heart, will know what the Spirit is praying. So that's why when you pray in tongues, the Spirit will help us and will help you to deliver from all the problems that will be coming in future. So when you pray in tongues, Spirit will help you to come out from all the problems that will come in the next year, in another year, in the forthcoming years. Spirit will help you. Hallelujah. So today I am telling you that. I am telling you one thing, that when you pray, God, in the book of Romans 8, chapter 8, 27 verse, it says that when you speak in tongues, when you pray in the Spirit, the Lord who looks into your heart will know what the Spirit is praying. But when I am telling you, when the Lord looks into your heart, if you are praying in tongues and thinking about something else, some other worldly things, when God looks into your heart, God won't answer your prayers, because that prayer, you're praying in tongues, you're praying in spirit, but in your heart you are thinking about something else. You're thinking about what God doesn't like. You're thinking about some worldly things which God doesn't like. So I'm telling you that when you pray, you must keep in mind the model prayer which Jesus has taught. When you pray in spirit, that means shaka bara baba lama. I'm praying in spirit. When I pray in spirit, I can think anything, but when I think anything, the God who looks into my heart won't answer my prayer, because in my heart is what I am thinking. In my heart is what I am thinking. So when I pray in the spirit, when I pray in tongues, what you have to keep in your mind is the model prayer which Jesus has taught. Shaki bala bhina baba. Let your kingdom come. When you pray in tongues, at the same time, you must keep in mind what Jesus has taught. What Jesus has said about the model prayer. Jesus has said, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So I am telling you, when you pray in spirit, when you pray in tongues, let the prayer that Jesus has taught be in your heart. Then surely you will see the blessings coming after one after another. After I have taken baptism, only very few times I have prayed for my personal matters. Always, every day when I pray, I only praise God. I pray in tongues. I praise God. Lord, maybe you will think, what you have to praise? Because you are having many problems, then how will you praise God? When you have problems, then only you must praise God. When Paul and other disciples, when they were put in the prison, when they praised, you know what happened? The foundation of the prison was shaken. Hallelujah. The foundation of the prison was shaken and they came out of the prison. So when you have problems, I am telling you, I am humbly telling you that when you have problems, do not go away, run away from your problems, but kneel down and pray in tongues. Maybe I see those people who are watching now, they have pain in their heart. They cannot succeed, they cannot come up in the ministry. But Holy Spirit is seeing you. You know why God has placed you in the place where you are. God has kept you in this city because God wants you to deliver many people through you. So you keep there. You sit in your house, wherever God has placed you. You sit there and you wait for the Lord. And Lord will lift you up in His, not in our time, in His time. Hallelujah. So, maybe you are having many finance problems. Maybe those who are watching through the media have many finance problems. They cannot come to the top level in the ministry. They have many problems in their family. They want to get their children to get married, but they have no money. They have diseases in their body, but the doctor says that there is no medicine to cure you. So there will be many problems like this. Don't listen to what the doctors say. Don't listen what the worldly people say. You kneel down and you pray to God. You know, David was a man who had many problems. He could not lift his head up because his problems were counted more than the number of hairs in his head. So he couldn't even lift up. But you know, he was thanking God. He wrote all the Psalms. He wrote all the Psalms when he was in the terrible position. When he was undergoing the trial, he wrote almost all the Psalms. How can a people write the songs? How can a people sing when he is undergoing any suffering? But when Jesus is with you, Jesus will help you. Jesus will help you to come out of the situation. God will be happy. When you are in the trial, when you are going under any temptation, don't think about the condition, what is now happening in you, but you just rely on God. Our God is able to come, help you to come out of this situation, because Jesus, when he was in this world, he was also tempted. He was also tempted by the world. He was also tempted by Satan, but he never allowed Satan or the world to come over him, because he overcame all the temptations. So today morning, when you cry to Jesus, Lord Jesus, I have many problems in my life. I want to grow up in the ministry. I want to work for you, Lord, but the finance is not opening for me. But today God is going to open finance for you. Let your plans, set aside all your plans. Let the plans of Jesus come to you, and let Jesus take control over you. Hallelujah. So God is going to do some miracles in your life. I am praying for you. If you close your eyes, I am going to pray for you. Before that, you must be a man of prayer like Daniel. Daniel was a man of prayer. The only complaint what the people in that kingdom told about was saying that he always prays. He whenever he gets time, he prays. So you must be a man of prayer. But don't pray like the heathens. You must keep in mind the model prayer which Jesus has taught you. And you praise God. You pray in tongues. So God will answer your prayers. And without any difficulty, you will see your prayer requests answered very soon. Without any difficulty. That's what in the book of Isaiah chapter 65, 24th verse, it says that before you sit down to pray, before you kneel down, I will answer your prayers. Our God knows what we know. Tomorrow what we know, our God knows. So your property won't be seized by the bank authorities. You won't be put to shame in the city where God has placed you, because God has placed you in the church at the right time, not in your time, in the time of Jesus, you will be lifted. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So let us close our eyes. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I am praying for those who are watching this message. They have many problems in their life. They cannot come up in the ministry. Mainly it is because of the finance problem. They want to start many conventions, but they cannot. They want to conduct many meetings, but they could not because of the finance difficulty. Lord, if it is your will, open the finances. I pray for the ministers. You open many openings in nations also, in countries, in other states, in other districts. And also I see many people who are having finance problems. Let the spirit of poverty, I rebuke in the name of Jesus. And let heaven be opened and you give finance which nobody could count, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus, those who are having disease in their body. I see a man who is afraid of his enemy. He is afraid of his enemy. In the name of Jesus, let the fear of God come over your enemy and let him run away and you be in peace. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus I pray. Lord, I pray for all the children, whatever they want for their education, you give them everything, Lord. They need textbooks, they need food, they need clothes, uniform, everything. You give everything, Lord. Those who are having church, those who are pastors, priests, you give believers to the, you add believers to the church, Lord. They should not lack anything. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. I see a person in the name, by the name Simon. He is always murmuring. He is thinking that he is not getting deliverance. But right now, he is in Ethiopia. Right now, God is delivering him from all your problems. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for you were with me. Thank you, Lord, for giving me a chance to preach about the model prayer. Let those who are hearing, those who have heard, and those who are going to hear, let them be blessed. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. So, God is with us. Today, God will bless you abundantly. So, keep in mind, whatever prayer request you have, you should not put these prayer requests before God, because our God knows whatever what you want. So you kneel down, you praise God. You simply praise God. Lord, I thank you. I thank you for everything. I thank you, Lord, for you gave me everything. I thank you, Lord, for you gave me this house. I thank you, Lord, for you gave me good health. I thank you, Lord. I praise you, God, for you gave me education. I thank you, Lord, for you gave me ministry. I thank you, Lord, for I am not having any disease. So many things. I thank you, Lord, for you have given me a good family. So you can give thanks. You can praise God for many blessings. Your thanks will be more than your prayer requests. So start praising God. Start giving thanks to God. Surely God will bless you. Surely God will change your position. Surely God will take you to another level. So by this time, tomorrow, your position will be changed in the name of Jesus, if you believe. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In Jesus' name, amen.